Alright, I had to leave for a small emergency. What was I doing? Oh yeah, I think I'm in the middle of a fight, aren't I? Oh, Q! Fucking
you can't
Q!
You fall down yet! You still got all your limbs! I think I've had about enough of this.
That's right, I'm on a revenge mission. Just got a little interrupted. I don't think stealth attacks work on them.
It seems you do possess some elixir of life. And it seems I will have to open you up again for exploration. For science!
Hey, bitch, the score's 1-1. I'm about to make you my slave.
You cannot kill an alchemist! I will be transmuted from this form into a golden warrior! You will see me again!
I guess no capture. I'll take it. But then I should have just killed him the first time. go kill this lucky little prick.
Let's see how fearsome they are now.
They love pain. It's time for them to feel some of their own.
Like the elves, Sauron values wisdom above all else. But for him, it is a cold, hard thing. He believes freedom is an empty virtue. He believes that Middle-earth seeks perfection in order. He believes that he will achieve what those before him could not.
In this, she speaks the truth.
Never thought I'd hear you say that.
Baenias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
It's all the boom booms. might switch to theirs one. Barely. Wait, what? Oh, fuck you. But I didn't run around like a jackass looking for a barrel for so long.
Of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
What am I doing in this menu? Really? So it randomly throws me in the fucking skill menu and then come out of it and get hit. Makes sense.
Phaenias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
Oh!
Sauron taught us a bitter lesson. Those in fear. Ones use grace to hide their true nature. That grace leads to trust, a weakness they can exploit. I see you. Sadras. Here in Mordor, loyalty passes from Orc to Captain to Overlord, and the chain of loyalty ends in a ring of power.
You serve the Bright Master!
Everyone in Mordor is ultimately... Rings themselves have no loyalty. Their wearers and their makers would do well to remember this. Get it lean. Close by. I can already hear their infernal singing.
Enough to come back. I'll make it more agonizing this time. Make you learn to stay dead.
I'm ready.
Die!
Revenge tour complete.
These Ologs are pillars of the War Chief's forces. Topple them.
It is a fundamental truth of Mordor. The orcs have been here far longer than men. Far longer than the Dark Lord himself, even. This place belongs to them, and in their own way, the orcs revere their heritage. We found this sword in a crude shrine, after all. Yet imagine what the orcs and Mordor could become if freed of the Dark Lord's corruption.
The orcs can temper a blade, I'll give them that.
They produce weapons in mass, but they give little care to each one.
Yeah. So angry, can't even talk. He's going to enjoy tearing you apart.
Not too sharp, quick. You won't get me that way!
Never even got his name.
I hear your voice, my lord.
Yes, my lord.
Stop!
Minas Ethel held many treasures far grander than this necklace, though none more precious to me. When I was a little girl, I would sneak into the Great Hall and take this necklace from its locked cabinet, thanks to a loose latch that only a child's hand could reach. For hours, I would admire myself in the mirror, imagining myself an elegant lady of Gondor, much like my mother must have been. My
Nice boss.
I'm surprised this necklace isn't hanging from some orc's neck.
Perhaps their stubby fingers cannot...
Do not resist!
The Analects of Ruvenir is a collection of advice from a long-ago Gondorian swordsman. It includes a series of exercises he guaranteed would lead to triumph in every duel. Like all young Gondorian soldiers, I studied the Analects a great deal, and I learned two key things. One, Ruvenir's swordsmanship was undoubtedly better than his penmanship. And two, in Ruvenir's time, duelists were far more courteous than the orcs of Mordor. War ignores such niceties.
A treatise on fine swordsmanship.
All too rare in these times. Such grace is lost on the denizens of Mordor.
Did you hear that?
Tharir.
Combat!
And now the hunt shall end.
Really, I just wanted to hang off the fucking ledge.
Why?
With this weapon, Tark, and the darkness takes all the fight out of you. You'll just lie down and it'll all be over.
On the on hem.
Sauron understood that power did not come from armies, but the willingness to sacrifice, to lie in wait. This is the truth he taught me, and so I lie in wait. And when the day comes, I will make my sacrifice.
She sacrificed the ring. She gave it to us.
There is calculation in her every move. We can never trust her.
Almost like they were put there just to be ripped off.
Ease it! He's not so fast!
Was that? It's too bad when they decided to copy Assassin's Creed 2, they also copied the worst parts like that.
Little of the Harrigan, mostly folk tales told around the campfire. The stories say they are fierce, pitiless warriors, as cruel as the orcs and as stern as the southern mountains beyond which they hail. Those folk tales convince many a Gondorian child to behave, but I cannot reconcile them with what I see in the only Harrigan I know, Beranor. He is fierce in battle and stern when needs must, but cruel? Never.
Such strange clothing.
And yet to the men of the south, it is as ordinary as your tunic. Only distance makes this precious.
He's trying to capture me!
No, I'm really not. Probably not run at me. Mission will lead me underground. Or maybe it's gonna break through the ground.
Tarbaroth! We call you to the shadows! Rise and join our glory! Rise and join the Shadows' army! Come to us! Rise! Rise! Rise!
What do they unearth?
They are summoning death. But it will be death for all.
Notice it says defeat on everything, not kill, which means I can dominate. Well, I see the way down now.
What an honor to meet the most famous dead man in Mordor. You really shook the world with that ring-forging trick of yours. After that, Targaroth only needed a little coaxing. Now, it rises to the surface, and it comes for you.
Zog.
Here. I will wake all the dead of Mordor before we're done. All the lives you ended. And once they're risen, who do you think they'll come for? Oh yes, we'll meet again. Swallowed by the darkness!
No one can tell.
Celebrimbor?
Not with the spirit of Karnan at our side.
Woken by death's ring, flames burn us. You woke him. You woke him.
Thank you.
we, Deathless One.
She is truly a power to be reckoned with.
The spirit of Karnan has witnessed Middle-earth's devastation and its revival many times over. She was here before any of us, and she will be here long after we have perished.
If we do not stop Torgoth, it will venture far beyond Mordor, to Rohan and Gondor.
That cannot happen.
Starting to pick shit I don't even care about. Alright, break time.